Although cement used to loop crowns to teeth has a high compressive strength, it does not withstand shearing and tearing forces very well. In order to avoid a break in the cement seal and displacement of the restoration from the tooth by functional stresses, every effort must be made to obtain mechanical retention in the crown preparation. The development of mechanical retention in a crown preparation is dependent upon two factors: cutting the axial walls as near parallel as possible, and obtaining as much length to the axial walls as possible. Gaining satisfactory retention in a crown preparation is relatively easy when working on a tooth of normal size and shape, if correct preparation procedures are observed. If the tooth to be crowned has an abnormal shape, or has lost some length, and/or parallelism of the axial walls, the basic principles of retention may be unobtainable. In these cases, it becomes necessary to modify the preparation to improve retentive qualities. The simplest method of obtaining additional retention in a crown preparation is by placing axial grooves on the buccal and lingual walls of the preparation. The grooves are cut with a 1/7 carbide burr and should extend from the occlusal to about 1 mm from the gingival finish line. The grooves should penetrate about 0.5 mm into the preparation and be approximately 1 mm wide. The taper of the burr will create the needed divergence of the grooves to the occlusal. The addition of proximal grooves to the crown preparation greatly enhances the retentive qualities of the preparation. Proximal boxes are often used on teeth with mesial or distal caries or old restorations, as they do not only improve the retention of the preparation, but also solve the problem created by the removal of the carious lesion or old restoration. Proximal boxes are cut with a number 171 carbide burr, and their design is similar to the proximal portion of an inlay preparation, sharp line angles and walls diverging slightly to occlusal.